understanding regular expression. What is regular expression? Regular expression is something we can see, the A star, B star is a regular expression. But if you say B square minus root over 4AC, it's a formula. Okay, B square minus root over 4AC divided by 2A, we know the formula. But is it regular expression? No. Why it is not regular expression? Because regular expression should not have, say A into B. It is a regular expression? No. Because regular expression should be only A concatenate with B. That's a regular expression. Or it can be A concatenate B with star. That means first come only 1A, then any number of B, that is called, the regular expression is called AB star. Or if you say I want only 1A, 1B at least, 1B at least, and then more, then I say A dot B dot B star, that is one way. Another is A dot B to the is the plus. So plus is one or more occurrence, and star means B, zero or more occurrence. That is called Clean's closure. Will come to this, but it is absolutely easy. You are using your these regular expressions from your childhood days. Child means as in whenever you are using computer, whenever you searching some computers like start.c or you search and replace command, these are nothing but regular expression. So regular expression is I can say a to the power n, b to the power n. Is it a regular expression? It is a regular expression. Why? Because a concatenate with m times e to the power m, and then b concatenate with n times. So there are various ways you can find it out regular expression. If you find it that any expression can be detected by finite state machine like a to the power m, b to the power n, you can easily detect it, m and n anything. You can accept it by a finite state machine. Then it must be regular expression. So regular expression, finite state machine, non-deterministic finite state machine, then regular set, all are same. It is not so obvious, so sometimes you get a lot of things whether it's a regular expression or not. So several ways you can check it. If you find it that you can acknowledge it by a finite state machine like a to the power m, b to the power m, if m are same, then it is not a regular expression. Why? Because whenever you want to determine, how I try it? I am trying it to a to the power m for mango, b to the power m for mango, to accept it by hardware, I need a stack. There is no alternative. You can say, I have a because I have finite state machine, I have a m a, then m b. But sometimes m plus 1 a comes, then your FSM has to be redesigned. But with a single stack, but the stack is infinite. Yeah, so that is stack. But you can say I can do it not with stack, I can do it to counter. Yes, I can count it. If m and n are counting, I need two counter. But that is way, that is easier to do, but that is easier. Toughest. Well, counter, I can say, in our old jokes, in our old childhood memory, you say, what you will say, I will say more than one. So that's it. See, if your counter is, counter say 100 bits, I say, no, I will give 100 bits plus one. So that's it. So counter isn't a solution. We need an infinite stack, and we will see it. Some notation is that in push-down automata, we have some stack alphabet that I already mentioned. One is sigma, that is input alphabet. One is stack alphabet gamma. Most of the groups use the stack alphabet, and the stack end of stack marker one symbol is there. That should not occur in your input string, that definitely, and that should not occur your stack string, that is the end of stack marker, that is called Z0. Most of the books are following. Okay, so coming back to the regular expression. So what is regular expression? Regular expression, you just see several ways you can find it out. If we see that a b star, a plus b, this kind of notation, this plus a plus b means union, regular set union. A plus b means a or b. Okay, a dot b means after a b comes. So these are all regular expressions, and everywhere with a plus sign and sprinkled over the star or the plus, that means any operation can be done, that is regular expression, and any regular expression can be converted to DFA. Then why, you can ask why the NFA comes up to there, but it has been found some very tough regular expression to build FA, DFA. This is a task we do often here, and that are the presentation you might can make. There are lots of regular expression. You cannot do DFA very obviously. We'll try one today. So there, if we make it from regular expression to NFA, then to DFA, it is easier. So that is it. Okay. Coming back to this, like stack is excellent like a union physics laboratory. You use the common balance. Whenever you are using the common balance, you do not need weights. With a common balance, you can always compare whether this ball is lighter or this ball is heavier. So with a common ball, common balance, if you have a 10 balls, 10s are similar look, everything, but one ball is simply lighter or heavier. With a common balls with minimum, say, 2 or 3 times, you can distinguish which ball is heavier and all this. So this is a kind of a puzzle. Like a physics laboratory, you don't need the measurement weight, and you need only common balance, and by repeatedly group, make them group and weighing together, you know which ball is defective. Same way, here, the purpose is the stack. So what is the stack? Stack is simply FSM, finite state machine, with a stack. Now, this is called push-down automata. Push-down automata, your push-down automata can detect your FSM language also. It's like any push-down automata can determine except the A to the power M, B to the power N. Okay, it can. Why? Because it simply acts as a finite state machine. It doesn't use the stack. But whenever it is A to the power N, B to the power N language, so when the A comes to the input string one at a time, because you know it's one at a time, it puts every A into the stack. And that A is become the stack alphabet, and that stack is input. Then when the A's are finished, then definitely there are N number of A's. Now B comes. Then whenever the B comes, he pop, because stack is only push and pop, he pop A and find it out that A or B are different. It is not B, so A and B. So he accepted and goes for the next B. Then he pops next A. So whenever A after N, and A to the power N, then the end of the B to the power N, all the A's will be popped off. Your stack should be empty. Am I correct? Your stack should be empty into A to the power N, B to the power N. Your stack should be empty. That is, when the stack is empty, whenever input string is empty, so you browse, you have a finite state machine reading head, generally called reading head. You're reading it from left to right, always left to right, unlike our Urdu language. It is like our simple English, left to right, not right to left. Okay, from left to right, we go one symbol at a time, or terminal at a time. So after every A, it doesn't throw A. He push the A into the stack, and then when the B comes, he compares with the A. One B, one A, then go ahead. Then if he found that it ends the, it is, if it fouls, like if there are remaining stack alphabets or remaining input, then it rejects the string. When the stack is empty and your input is empty, then you say it is a push-down automata. That is, it's a deterministic context-free grammar. Take the example, A to the power N, B to the power 2N. Okay, whether it is a deterministic context-free grammar. Common test is you mentally simulate with the stack, and here part 2B signal, you pop 1A. Are you getting my point? A to the power N to B to the power 2N. So part 2B, whenever you see the 2B, then you pop 1A. Okay, the same, like any relation between integer relation, say A to the power 2N, B to the power 5N, it can be done. Just you think yourself. A to the power 6N, B to the power 7N, it can be also done by similarly. But if we say, I have a alphabet, I have alphabet only one character, that is A. Although A, no B. I have a sigma A. My language is A to the power P. P is a prime number. Okay. So, A to the power P. Whether it can be done by a finite state machine? No. Because your infinite numbers are infinite. You know infinite. So, how can you design a finite state machine so that it can accept a single character alphabet A to the power P? Same is A to the power N square. It is not possible for finite state machine, even PDA, to detect A to the power P language. So, you need a more sophisticated machine. That sophisticated machine is Turing machine. But the strange is, I want to summarize. Summarize is A to the power M, B to the power X is a regular language. Why? There is no relation between M and X. A to the power M, B to the power Q, regular language. A to the power M, B to the power N, regular language. A to the power M, B to the power M, N, same. Then you have to compare. How to compare? By a stack. Now, I to the power N, C to the power N, all are same. This is again not possible by a pushdown automata. You need two stack. That is too difficult. It cannot be done. We will go back to Turing machine. So, these are the different types of language you have to understand. And the language has to be accepted by hardware. What is language? Language is nothing but a grammar. And we have some starting variable. We have some production rule. We have some alphabet. We can, with the production rule, we can generate infinite languages. Okay, so that is interesting. Finite languages are stupid. It can be done by a combinatorial circuit. So it is very easy. Finite language. So yes, no, very good type. Yes, no, very good. Okay. So, these are five sentences, it has to be accepted. It can be done by a combinatorial circuit. Whenever infinite language, then there are layers of language. The first easiest is a type 3 language, that is a regular language. Regular language, all our mechanical machines, even lots of our protocols, our lift agency, our ambassador machine, whatever complex machine you are seeing without computer in the place or anything, they are all the finite state machine. Then the immense power comes whenever you add a little bit of an infinite stack. Whenever the stack is there with the finite state machine, then it can understand many, many powerful languages. What are the powerful languages? The one is deterministic context free grammar. A to the power n, B to the power n, or balance parenthesis. So, opening brace, open, or that, you have to match the parenthesis. These are the simplest of the deterministic context-free grammar. But the beauty of it, all these deterministic context-free grammar takes your 99.9% of your programming language. We are discussing formal language, but the programming language are nothing but a extension of a formal language. So, programming language are nothing but, you can say, a deterministic context-free grammar. Okay. You might ask, what is non-deterministic context-free grammar? Yes, that is, I have told you again and again, that is a palindrome. Okay, palindrome is the palindrome which, like madam, I am madam, if you, this way you can ask way, or Ramakanta Kamar. There are lots of palindromes are there in the various literature. So, this palindrome detection, it can be done by non-deterministically a pushdown machine, and that is very, very difficult in done. That cannot be done basically. We can always think it is a midpoint. We know, so that is called context-free grammar, but that is a non-deterministic context-free grammar that is done by non-deterministic pushdown automata, which cannot be designed. It is a theoretical, but unlike deterministic finite state machine and non-deterministic finite state machine are same, power is same, power means everything is same, that is recognizability is same, non-deterministic FSM is give the advantage only to capture the from the regular expression, and later on you step by step convert to deterministic finite state machine. Epsilon and psi are two different things. Epsilon means empty string. If nothing happens, it happens. It's a very, very empty string is accepted. Here nothing is accepted. So, it is a complete black and here is complete white. You can like it. It's anything it has, this is a language, there is always empty string. But these two are different. Language consists of empty string and language consists of shy are different. You see, there is no final state, then it is definitely the language will be shy. And whenever say enter signal input and it's the same final state, then if nothing is accepted, that is epsilon is accepted. Design a regular expression to non-deterministic final state equation. See here, we have a language expression R plus S. R plus means either R or S. So basically this is a FSM hardware R and S. I create a new start state and I connect it to epsilon. We are not proof in the class yet, but we already told you non-deterministic FSM machine and FSM machine are same. So whatever we do, we do FSM, this is a deterministic FSM machine. I create a new start, I go to epsilon here, and epsilon here. So this is the expression of R plus S. It is a non-deterministic FSM, but it can be done, deterministic FSM. You have to believe it. This is the language, say here, this is RS. So here this is R, epsilon S. And this is the R star, this is your, closer. What is R star? I'm going to epsilon here R, again go back to another state. From here to here I can jump to epsilon, and here to here I can jump to epsilon. So this is a nothing but R star. Zero or more occurrences of R. Zero or more occurrences of R. I think this is nothing but you can see why the states are coming. In finite state machine, though we call it finite, but it is a basically infinite. You can call machine, but it should be infinite in the sense it should be enumerable. What is enumerable? Like, but it ultimately is a big state number, but it doesn't have a stack. Jump it to epsilon. So this is a design block. You have to remember this design block. Let's try another design block. Here we wish to do. This is a regular expression given. Okay, we have to do the design block of non-deterministic FSM machine. The first we have done, whatever this part, A plus B, only this part, this is the A plus B part. So we have to design full A dot, but we are first designing A plus B, and this is A plus, this whole diagram is nothing but this portion, A plus B. Okay, you not even start. Basically, A plus B, first of all, it is A or B. I remember, it is not like 3 plus 2, it is not 5. It is not arithmetic plus operation. It is OR operation. Either 3 or 2 certain kind of thing. So this is a, see here this is the expression of A plus B. What is A plus B? In regular expression, it is A plus B. Remember my earlier lecture, I have told you regular expression and regular set are equivalent, but regular set, it is written A union B. A union B. That is, that from a set theoretic knowledge, you know, I can go through A or I can go through B. So this A plus B, is nothing but A union B in regular set. And this is a regular expression. So I have make a hardware. This is the hardware A portion. This is the hard accepting A only. And this portion hard accept B only. And I can put epsilon here, because epsilon means NDFA can be converted to DFA, and epsilon is, this is the final state and this is the starting state. This is nothing but an expression either A or B. If you start here, you can go either Eastern Metropolitan Bypass A, or you can go CIT Road Baniktala here, but you can reach Uttarama. So this is either this path, Eastern Metropolitan Bypass, or this is I can go to CIT Maniktala, I can reach Uttaraga from Koshwa. This is A plus B, this is A or B. So this is a regular expression. It is what it says. These expression either have A or B or both, and any number of concatenation. It should start with A and it must end with 2B. You have to design the hardware. This is a regular expression, it must start 1A, then either A or B, any number of occurrence, and then it must end with 2b. So I have done only a plus b operation. That is a OR operation. This is now automation a plus b star. What are they? Remember, this is a plus b and this is your a plus b star. You put lots of epsilon here and here. This is your a plus b star. This is see any R. How to make R star? So this is R. And then you can make another epsilon. Then you can make back to epsilon. Here you can jump. So this means zero occurrence of R. You can go. This is zero occurrence of R. And this means one occurrence of R. And this means multiple occurrence of R. Non-deterministic FSM capture R star. Now instead of R, think of A plus B. Whatever A plus B we have done, you put into it and then make a diagram. So let's see. This is A plus B. Then I have to make A plus B star. So this is like our R star. Basically A or B. I remember it is not like 3 plus 2. It is not 5. It is not arithmetic plus operation. It is OR operation. Either 3 or 2 certain kind of thing. So this is a, see here this is the expression of A plus B. What is A plus B? In regular expression it is A plus B. That is, that from a set theoretic knowledge you know, I can go through A or I can go through B, any one. So this A plus B, this A plus B is nothing but A union B in regular set. And this is a regular expression. So I have make a hardware. This is the hardware A. Agree? Or you just concentrate with I. This is the hard accepting A only. And this proportion hard accept B only. And I can put epsilon here. Because epsilon is in DFA can be converted to DFA. And epsilon is, this is the final state. And this is the starting state. This is nothing but an expression either A or B. If you start here, you can go either Eastern Metropolitan Bypass A, or you can go you can go CIT Road Baniktala here, but you can reach Ultradanga. So this is either this path, Eastern Metropolitan Bypass, or I can go to CIT Baniktala. I can reach Ultradanga from say Koshwa. This is A plus B, not this is A or B. So this is a regular expression. It is what it says. These expressions either have A or B or both, and any number of concatenation. It should start with A and it must end with 2B. You have to design the hardware. This is a regular expression. It must start 1A, then either A or B, any number of occurrence, and then it must end with 2B. So I have done only A plus B operation. That is A OR operation. Now automation A plus B star. What are they? Remember, this is A plus B and this is your A plus B star. You put lots of epsilon here and here. This is your A plus B star. Remember my earlier block? See here. This is see any R. How to make R star? So this is R and then you can make another epsilon. Then you can make back to epsilon. Here you can jump. So this means zero occurrence of R. You can go. This is zero occurrence of R. And this means one occurrence of R. And this means multiple occurrence of R. Non-deterministic FSM capture R star. Now instead of R, think of A plus B. Whatever A plus B we have done, you put into it and then make a diagram. So this is A plus B. Then I have to make A plus B star. So this is like our R star in the previous diagram. This is you just A plus B. And this is you put epsilon here. So I must have one A plus B or I have multiple A plus B. Multiple A plus B. Either A or B. Not together. Either A or B. Maybe first time I go to A. Second time I choose B. That is possible. Either A or B. Okay. Or I can jump from here to final. I am not doing any A plus B, just going down. That is A plus B star. So I am doing A plus B star. And I can go back here, this. Yeah, this is A plus B star. See here, So this is, see here, this is A plus B, this is A plus B, this is A plus B star. Now I give them both pictures. This is A plus B, this is the ball diagram A plus B, and this is A plus B whole bracket star. That is either A plus B multiple, like R star. Okay. Now I have to design more. I have to design A dot A plus B star then 2B. Then what will be the diagram? Yeah. So this is the consideration of only 1A. 1A. This is the earlier diagram. Okay, you see this I am pushing. Here I add only 1A. My ultimate diagram is A, this is diagram A dot A plus B star. Now this is the diagram of A plus B star. Then last is entry many epsilon. Epsilon is your free, like your it is anything you can go for epsilon. But it can be done by deterministic FSM machine. So here the non-deterministic FSM machine is easier to design your deterministic finite-state machine. From capturing regular expression to DFA, your non-deterministic FSM machine is great. Okay, like here you can see. Now we have done A dot, now go for next stage. Here we say A dot A dot 2B. So I add 1B here, 1B here. What is the purpose? Whenever you search for a file, see, I want to search for a file I think you have used DOS. All the, in your search and replace command, in your Word, find, search and replace, you are basically, that's a regular expression. Regular expression you heavily used. Like in your, whenever you search start.c, start.java, in your directory, whenever you know Windows search file, search, so you have used it. So that's a regular expression. What is star? Star means either zero or more number of occurrence. Okay, that is called regular grammar. Regular grammar is even like, say, variable declaration. So in your C, you have to variable declaration. It must start with a alphabets and any number of characters or alphabet and numericals, but there should not be white space. So who will dictate? It is nothing but you can replace, you can use it by a deterministic DFA by regular expression. By regular expression, I must say it starts with a ASCII, is a alphanumeric, not alpha, not numeric. So you, and then it can be numeric or alphanumeric. So your variable should start, must be with a ABC something, and then it can be 1, 2, 3, 4, but there should not be semicolon and all these things. It can be detected by a finite state machine. In fact, it's done that. In all your programming languages, I have told in my last class, the first step is lexical analysis. What the lexical analysis does? So in your programming language C or Java, we told you that you give the variable name as much as you can, but not too big, but it should have, you should not have shorthand. It is general practice. So we say, don't shortcut it, like you give the number NUMBER, not NO, because some programmer may use NO, some programmer is the number. So it is better to use the full name. So whenever you have the full name, see, even your program looks huge, you might think if your variable name is huge, it might take bigger space in your computer memory. No, because actually it is, everything is converted to a token. So whether you give a short name, whether if you give 250 character name, ultimately it will be token by something integer. So this will be all taken care of by lexical analysis, and there is a machine, not several machines, which can detect it, whether it's an integer, whether it's a floating point number, whether it's a variable, how it can be done. This kind of machine. So this finite state machine detect the whether it is a variable, whether it's a keyword, whether it's a semicolon, whether it's a opening brace, closing brace, and give some number. So this is nothing but a regular expression. So regular expression is very, very, very powerful. But it cannot be done in, but you cannot make it full-fledged writing program. I have told earlier classes, regular expression is very powerful, like grep VI editor, I search and replace command. So here the regular expression is you have used star or wildcat character in semicolon. So regular expression is very powerful, but you cannot do programming. Why? Because programming you need repeated function call, procedural call. But it is, regular expression doesn't support opening brace and closing brace. So there you need a push-down automaton. Programming, you need a stack. So you need a programming language. So then you need a deterministic context-free machine grammar, deterministic context-free grammar, and push-down automaton, deterministic push-down automaton. This diagram, so that is the use of it. You can have a, basically in, whenever in a compiler, we have a several machine which detect whether it's an integer, one machine detect whether a floating point number, one machine detect whether it's a variable name, whether another machine it catches keywords. Like whenever you are running a compiler, in the first stage, whenever you are running a compiler by command CC or GCC, the first stage is lexical analysis. Another program takes in your program and try to generate the tokens, and if it is found that your variable name starts with integer, so it will reject, it will give a lexical error. Okay, after a lexical analysis is done, then it comes the syntax analysis, then it is done by a deterministic context with grammar and all these things. Then you check the production rules of the grammar, but before that, whether the variables are correct or you have semicolon are there or not, it will be checked by the, not by the rule of the grammar, it is by the, whether it's a variable or not, by this regular expression. So regular expression is highly used in the lexical stage, not highly used, it's more 99% used. It basically comes from regular expression. Get regular expression, that is the full form of grep. Grep command means LS, all are regular expression, even our DOS command. Like start the state theorem, I think next class I wish to go for this Arden's theorem, but I think this is a challenging thing. It states that P and Q do regular expressions. P doesn't contain null string, this is string. So if this is a expression, it must be solution at this, like this. So this is the way we simplify, you can simplify the regular expression. If you can find out this kind of expression, so theorem is one, good, you can